Hello everyone, this is Dude Blender, and let's jump right in. We're making these three materials, wood, plastic, and brushed aluminum, in less than a minute each. Let's start with the brushed aluminum. So, create a shape. I'll use a cube with subdivision and cast to sphere modifiers. Create a material and name it aluminum. Now, in the shading workspace, we'll turn the metallic all the way up and set a grayish white color. Add a noise texture, and with the node wrangler enabled, control T to add the coordinate mapping nodes. Use the object texture coordinate. Now, at this point, if you scale the shape in any way, remember to apply the scale with Ctrl A. Now add a bump node. Change the mapping scale in any direction by a large number, something like 200. Finally, adjust the bump strength and distance to 0.1 and 0.01 respectively. Aluminum, done. Note that since we're scaling the texture in one direction, the texture will not have the finish on the sides. Of course, you could fix this by using a UV map, but in this video, we want to keep it very simple, so we're not going to do that. Make any changes to the color, to the scale, and to the bump until you're happy with the texture, and let's move on to the next one. Now, for the wood material, we're actually gonna use the aluminum node tree as a starting point. So duplicate the shape, duplicate the material, and rename it to wood. We'll slide back the metallic to 0, and we'll reduce the scale to something like 10. Now we'll reduce the other two dimensions to 0.1. We're gonna use this node texture to add the color. So connect a color ramp. It's always a good idea to use color references. I use Adobe Color. Go to Explore, search for wood, and click on whichever color palette you like best. I think I'll go with this one. Copy one of the colors by clicking on it, and then paste it on the hex value of one of the colors of the ramp. Copy a different color to the other one in the ramp. Connect the color ramp to the shader if you haven't done so already. Now let's change the bump strength to 0.5. Now, to indicate the knots of the wood, we're gonna add a Voronoi texture before the noise texture and change the feature to Smooth F1. And you're basically done. Now you can fine-tune the mapping scale and the bump node values to your liking. You can even add more colors to the ramp. This is how my node tree ended up looking. Now to plastic, fantastic. I found this plastic close-up image in Google that I will use as reference. This looks very much like a Musgrave texture, so that's what we're gonna use. Create a new shape and new material, and we'll call it plastic. Now we'll add a Musgrave texture node connected to a color ramp. Control shift and left click on the ramp to visualize it. Change the scale on the Musgrave texture node to a very large number, something like 1000. You can lower the detail, dimension, and lacunarity a little bit. Now adjust the color ramp to sharpen the transition between the higher and lower parts of the texture. Now let's connect it to a bump node and connect the bump to the shader. Strength should be around 0.6. Distance will change to something very small, like 0.001. Now visualize the shader again. I'll adjust the color ramp a little bit more. Now you can change the color and the roughness if you want to give it more or less shine, and you're done. There you go, three stylized materials that are lightning fast to set up, and honestly, they look awesome. That's it for today. Drop a like, comment, and subscribe if you like the video, and connect with me on TikTok and Instagram with the handle @dude_blender. I'm Dude Blender. Happy blending.